just finished an interview at the Bartlesville Examiner, and it was very interesting because he asked me, well, what are some of the new sources of revenue? I said, well, let's just talk about cannabis. Let's talk about reducing incarceration. Let's talk about ending privatization schemes. Let's talk about allowing the TSET money to be accessed for vulnerable populations. There are millions of solutions, but nobody's willing to talk about them because they won't make any money off of them. I have probably the lowest base run funding campaign of all of the candidates. He asked me, well, what are those two people doing for you? Do they get paid? He asked them, I said, no, we just volunteered. So we may not have money, but we have about 2,000 volunteers in our database. And if you ascribe $100 to each one of those, we've got the money, we've got the passion, we've got the energy, we've got the belief that it's time for a drastic change in Oklahoma. Now, when you look at me, you're going to see the most different candidate in the race. I'm serious. I'm the only woman, and I'm the only person of color. But I'm also the one that has 35 years of experience knowing the front and the back end of the process. I've been there when the legislature was Democrat. I've been there when it was tied. I've been there when it was Republican, and I couldn't wait to get out of there. But I've also served on the 3 Democratic governors and 3 Republican governors. I know what Frank Keaton did in 1996 when he ushered in private prisons in Oklahoma, and his wife owned the property where the first one was built. I'm disgusted driving up the turnpike to see that now CCA has morphed into Core Civics so that it can do treatment and, again, find the money. I'm submitting to you that if you're ready for a change, we can't do incremental change in Oklahoma. We are at our wit's end. We're the worst in everything good, and we're the best in everything bad. And it's time for us to do a 180-degree adjustment and to actually change directions in Oklahoma. I believe we can do that. I'm asking you for your vote. The primary is June 26th. There's one less candidate now. I believe that other candidate is, you know, he tried in 2010 and nothing happened. And so now it's time. Let's go with someone who is fresh out of the agenda, fresh out of the arena, who has a clue about how we got here in the first place. Because that's what you need to reverse what's going on. Our website is connieforgovernor.com. You can go there, sign up to volunteer. I wish you would sign up to donate. We're not a high-spending campaign. We've got t-shirts, we've got placards, we've got buttons. We use gas to travel to places. But we need your help. We need you to consider making a monthly contribution to our campaign. It can be $10. In 6 months, that's $60. Well, that's like a half a box of buttons. I'm so happy again to be here. Thank you for inviting me, and I would be happy to answer any questions. Oh, the last piece, text Connie. You can text Connie to 63566, and that will get you a link that will take you to our website immediately. Are there any questions?